I welcome you all for this video tutorial. In this video, we will discuss the computational models in embedded system design. Especially, we are going to discuss about state machine model. There are six different models are there. First one is data flow graph model, DFG. Second one is controlled data flow graph model, state machine model, sequential program model, concurrent or communicating process model. Then last one, object-oriented model. See, these computational models are helpful to create or write codes for an embedded system. Code means programs. Group of programs will create software. Usually, software part in an embedded system is called as firmware. So, by the way, with the help of these different kind of computational models, you can able to build your firmware. So the state machine model, this is one type of computational model which is very useful for developing the firmware, such kind of applications where the different kind of states will be there. Okay, we will discuss one example, two examples for this kind of computational models. First we will look for what is state machine model. So it is suitable for event-driven embedded systems. Event-driven means if a signal A is coming into the system, means what kind of action to be taken. If A is not entering into the system, means what kind of action to be taken. If B is coming into the system, means what the action to be taken. If it is not received, I mean B is not received, means what type of action to be taken. So this is what we are called as event-driven model. Okay, depends upon the signal whatever we are getting into the system, one particular event will be executed. This is event-driven model. So processing behavior is based on state transition. Okay, so state, I mean one particular this is completely the whole system is this particular computational model is suitable for the system where the complete working is divided into some set of states. Okay, so we will go through the example. While going through the example, we can able to get what is mean by state. Then state machine model is drawn for the development of a program. Okay, if you want to write if you want to develop a firmware for a particular embedded application, you should draw the state machine model. Okay, by referring this state machine model, you can able to write the codes. And one state machine model consists of state, events, actions, transitions. There are four terms: state, events, action, and transition. So state means a representation of a current situation. Okay, state means representation of current situation. For example, in your charge level in your mobile phone, if it is showing 50%, means it is showing the current state of the battery. I mean current status of the charging level in the battery. Okay, if it is showing 100%, means it is full charge state. If it is showing less than 20%, means it means it is being in low power mode. So these are all the two states in our mobile phone. Okay, if it is the battery level is 100%, means the mobile phone being in full charge mode. If it is less than 20%, means it is in low battery mode. Okay, so this is what we are called as states. And events, input to the state. Okay, so in our mobile phone itself, there are two states, I already told you, full battery mode, low battery mode. If low battery mode, if the battery is entering into the low battery mode, what we have to do is we have to execute one event. We have to execute one event called displaying the message like the battery is low. This is the event what we have to execute whenever the battery is going into the low battery mode. So event is nothing but input to the state. Whenever the state concerned state arrives, what type of input we have to give into the system. If it is entering into low battery mode, the message should be displayed. Okay, kindly put the mobile into charge. this is the message, this is the event to be executed whenever the low battery mode is reached. Whenever the full battery mode reached, the message should be please unplug the charge. This is the message to be displayed. Okay, so event is nothing but the input to the state. Okay, the next transition. Transition is nothing but movement from one transition, one state to another state. Okay, so transition means whenever the state reached, the event will be displayed. Okay, event will be displayed, and then what type of actions, I mean events will be displayed, and what it will the system will be moved from low battery mode to full battery mode. Okay, this is the transition, state transitions, right? The last one, actions, activity to be performed. Okay, whenever the state reached, event is nothing but the displaying the message. What is the action to be performed? This program should be executed, that small kind of program, in order to display the message. That program execution is the action to be performed. Okay, so finally, if number of states are finite, the state machine model is called as finite state machine, FSM. Okay, so even though all the embedded systems are having finite number of states, okay, either for the case of battery charging in our mobile phone or laptop, there are two states, right? Full battery mode, low battery mode, there are two states. Likewise, depending upon the embedded systems, depending upon the application, depending upon the physical device you concern, the states, number of states may be finite. Okay, so let me see a classical example for this state machine model. For example, we are going to consider seatbelt warning alarm in an automobile. Okay, seatbelt warning systems. Okay, so whenever the vehicle ignition is turned on, okay, so this is the actual thing whatever we are following in these seatbelt warning systems. Okay, whenever the vehicle ignition is turned on and the seatbelt is not fastened within 10 seconds. Okay, so initially vehicle ignition will be on, and then seatbelt will not be fastened. After 10 seconds, if it is continued, means okay, for 10 seconds of ignition on and seatbelt is off, okay, then the system generates an alarm for 5 seconds. Okay, this is the automatic seatbelt warning alarm in our automobiles, and the alarm will be turned off. The first case, this is the condition for turning on the alarm. Second point, this is a condition for turning off the alarm. Okay, the alarm is turned off when the alarm time expires. Okay, whenever the alarm time expires, it should be turned off. Otherwise, if the passenger or driver fastened the belt, okay, if he wear the belt, the alarm should be turned off. And if the ignition switch, the engine is getting off, then the alarm is not needed, right? There are three conditions for turning off the alarm. One is that alarm time expires, and then the seatbelt is fastened, and then ignition switch of the engine is turned off. These are all the three conditions for turning off the alarm. Okay, when the alarm should be turned on, okay, for a 10 seconds of ignition on, seatbelt off state, means the alarm has to turn on for 5 seconds. Okay, this is the actual thing whatever we followed for seatbelt warning alarm, warning systems, right? So let me draw the state machine model for this case. Okay, so there are three states are there. While focusing on alarm as the final output, this is the very important thing. Alarm is our objective. Okay, turning on the seatbelt alarm is our main objective of this particular product. So there are three states. What are the three states are there? There are three states: alarm off, waiting, and alarm on. Okay, alarm off is nothing but the initial state of that particular device or product. Waiting is nothing but it has to wait for 10 seconds. Am I right? If the ignition is on and seatbelt is off for 10 seconds, after checking 10 seconds of that two conditions, then only the alarm has to be on. So for the case of alarm circuit, there are three states: alarm off, waiting, alarm on. There are three states are there. This is what we are called as finite machine model. Okay, finite state machine model. Okay, alarm off, waiting, alarm on. The next, so I told you, right? Alarm off is nothing but the starting state of this particular product. So whenever if you are going through any kind of state machine model, you should know what is the starting point, where from where the state machine model is start to draw, like. So you have to know that this is the kind of state where the whole operation gets start. So alarm off, we have to start from alarm off. Okay, if ignition key is on, okay, ignition key is on, then it is waiting, it is the alarm is going for waiting stage. Okay, so and then seat belt is off. Okay, ignition is on, the engine, the vehicle engine is getting on, then the alarm off state should be converted, the state, there will be a state transition from alarm off to waiting state. Okay, so now seat belt is off. Okay, vehicle engine is on and seat belt is off. I mean the driver is not fastened the belt, seat belt. Now immediately the state is alarm on state. Okay, the alarm should be turned on. Okay, what you have to do is we need to turn on the alarm for 5 seconds. Okay, when the alarm on, the state will transit from alarm on to on F, alarm off. Are you able to understand? Alarm on state to alarm off state will be transited whenever three conditions are satisfied. One is alarm time expires, seat belt off, ignition key off. If alarm time expires, the alarm has to be turned off and it has to again check out whether the ignition key is on and seat belt off, means immediately the next alarm will be turned on. If the alarm time expires, it has to be turned off immediately and then check the condition and turned on. This is the regular cycle. Whatever, if no seat belt is turned on but the engine is on, means this is the straight transition circle. Okay, alarm off, waiting, alarm on, time expires, alarm off, waiting, alarm on. This is the cyclic process. Okay, then if suppose after getting the alarm sound, if the driver or passenger fastens his or her seat belt, immediately the alarm should be turned off. This is in second condition. Okay, alarm initially getting off, the driver is turning on the ignition key and not wearing the seat belt, and alarm is turned on. After knowing that alarm itself, the driver is just wearing the seat belt, so then the alarm is turned off. So this is the simple cycle. Okay, so the system is initially giving the alarm. After getting the alarm, the driver is wearing the seat belt. The process is over. The alarm is turned off. Okay, and then the driver is turning on the key. This is third case. The driver is turning on the key. The alarm is waiting, but not wearing the seat belt. The alarm is turned on, but unfortunately the driver switch off the ignition key. It may be the checking of engine condition. For the purpose of checking the engine condition itself, he turned on the key, ignition key, and immediately he turned off. So no need to continue the seatbelt alarm. Okay, so it may started once. Whenever the ignition key off, the system should be completely shut down. So immediately the alarm gets off. So these are all the three different conditions for switching off the alarm. Okay, so this is the state machine model for the automatic seat belt alarm warning systems. In this particular example, states are nothing but alarm off, waiting, alarm on, and event is nothing but input to the state. Am I right? So what kind of event you are setting up? Ignition key is on means the state input, the state should be transited from one state to another. If the seat belt is off, so see, these are all the events. Okay, these are all the registered event for this state machine model. And transition means this is the transition of state 1 to state 2, state 2 to state 3. This is the transition. And then action to be performed is alarm should be off, alarm should be on, waiting. This is the action to be performed. Okay, alarm off means there will be a timer within that system. Okay, if you want to turning off the alarm, means the timer will be cleared. Okay, the timer register will be there. based upon the configuration type, it may be 8 bit, 16 bit, 32 bit. The timer register will be cleared. This is the actual concept behind that actual action to be performed behind that state, alarm off. Okay, so waiting state means it needs to wait for 10 seconds. Okay, so the hexadecimal codes that is equivalent for 10 seconds, okay, will be loaded on that particular timer registers. For that particular period, the alarm will be waiting. Okay, this is what we are called as waiting state. So behind this state, there will be an action, which means 10 seconds, the hexadecimal equivalent for 10 seconds will be loaded into the timer. So this is these actions are based on only timers, right? Alarm on means immediately it should turn on the buzzer, right? So alarm on is nothing but whenever this state reached, what action to be taken, immediately it needs to create some beep sound. Okay, so this is the action behind this state. So these are all the various parts of the state machine model we discussed so far about automatic seatbelt warning systems. So we are having states, event, transition and actions. This is a complete classical example for this state machine model. And then this is one more example for state machine model, tea or coffee vending machine. Okay, so this is an automatic vending machine. Vending machine is nothing but an automatic seller. Another name is automatic seller. If you are putting any kind of coin or rupees into that system, corresponding product will be dispensed automatically. Okay, so if you want to design a vending machine, okay, apart from the hardware parts, while designing a firmware for this vending machine, this is very difficult because this is a continuous process. This is an event-driven model. Okay, so if the user is putting 5 rupees coin into that vending machine, okay, next thing it has to asking for whether he is in the need of tea or coffee. So based upon the user input, that action to be taken by that vending machine automatically. Okay, if I am pressing tea button, means tea should be dispensed. If I am pressing coffee button, means coffee should be dispensed. So this is what we are called as event driven model, based upon the user interruption, based upon the user input, based upon the user intervention, the action will be taken. Okay, so this is not a continuous action. This is not equivalent to while looping. Okay, so whatever may be the input, that there will be a continuous action. Okay, that is what we are called as while looping. This is not a looping action, this is event driven model. So something depends upon the external input. That external input will be given by the user. Okay, so you can see this state machine model for this vending machine. So in this state machine diagram, you should start from this kind of state. Okay, wait for user input. IP means user input. Okay, in order to understand the basics of this state machine model, you should start from this state. Okay, wait for user input. Okay, wait for user input. Wait for coin. Sorry, wait for coin. Okay, you have to start from this particular state. Am I right? Wait for coin. Okay, so whatever the machine is, always wait for the coin. Okay, so we are not bothering about what type of coin, how many coins we are putting into that machine. We are not discussing that concepts in this particular state machine model. It is assumed that we will always insert correct 5 rupees coin into the system. This is an assumption. Okay, there will be a separate state machine model for analyzing the input to the system. Okay, if you are giving 5 1 rupees coins, okay, what the system has to be done, I mean what type of display the system has to be delivered, that kind of assumption we didn't cover in this state machine model. We assumed that the user will always give a single 5 rupees coin. Okay, this is an assumption what we made. You can consider this is an ideal tea or coffee vending machine. Okay, the user will always give a equal size of 5 rupees coin always. This is an assumption, right? So initial state is wait for coin. Okay, whenever the user is inserting a coin, 5 rupees coin, okay, so event is nothing but the input to the state. Okay, so the machine is being in the state called wait for coin. What event now we executed, the user inserted the coin. Okay, event is nothing but input to the state. Am I right? So I'm inserting 5 rupees coin into that machine. What action it will be taken? Action is okay. Okay is nothing but it is receiving that 5 rupees coin, and based upon the size, based upon the weight, it will consider this is a 5 rupees, exact 5 rupees coin what we desire. Okay, the action means okay. The next state can be moved. The machine can be moved on to the next state. This is the action to be performed. What is the next state? Next state is wait for input, user input. Okay, after inserting the coin, the display has to be whether you are in the need of tea or coffee. This is the question asking in front of us. Okay, that may be asking into the LCD or LED or OLED display. Okay, so the system is asking for the user input. Okay, so immediately the display will be there. Okay, so we are pressing, just assume if I am pressing T button. Okay, event input to this state is T button pressing. Okay, I am pressing T button. Immediately what will be happen? The whole state machine model, the state transition will be there. State transition from wait for user input to dispense T state. Okay, immediately dispense T. The state, the complete machine will be state transited. Okay, from wait for user input to dispense T. Okay, during this dispense T state, there will be a motor that is driving. Okay, there will be a pumping motor that will be driven, and that equal amount of T will be dispensed through that particular valve, and that place itself there will be a cup, so automatically it will be filled by T, and then there will be a light indicator in that particular machine that indicates that the tea filling process, tea dispensing is over. These are all the things whatever we are happening, we have to do during the state of dispensing tea. Okay, so event is nothing but tea dispensed, action is done. So that state transition will be come back to the initial state called wait for coin. Okay, so we inserted the coin, we press the tea button, T is dispensed, again the system is coming back to the original state called wait for coin. This is the event whatever we followed for getting the T from the vending machine. Okay, if suppose during the wait for input, user input state, if you are pressing coffee, means immediately the state transition will be wait for user input to dispense coffee state. Okay, immediately it will dispense the coffee, the same progress it will follow for dispensing the coffee, and then after dispensing the coffee successfully, it will come back to the original state called wait for coin. Okay, if suppose I am inserting the coin 5 rupees, okay, it is displaying tea coffee, I am expecting for cold coffee. If it is not given by that particular machine, means I am just pressing the cancel button. Okay, what the system immediately what is the action to be executed immediately? The coin should be came out from that machine. This is the action to be performed. Okay, after pressing the cancel button itself, the coin should be immediately returned by the machine. Okay, this is the action. So you can see this transition from wait for user input to wait for coin. There will be an action. The action is nothing but sending the coin out. Okay, so this is the overall state machine model diagram for the tea or coffee vending machine. There are several cases that we already we did consider for this case of vending machine. For example, if the tea, okay, if that container is not having sufficient amount of tea, if the container is not having sufficient amount of coffee, means it should be displayed to the user. Okay, that cases are not considered in this case, in this particular state machine model. Okay, if you are considering all type of coins, okay, if you are considering checking the coins, checking the tea container, coffee container, means the state machine model will be very difficult to understand. Okay, for the simple understanding, we are considering an ideal machine, and if you are inserting one coin, that will dispense tea or coffee to us. This is the simple operation. In order to execute this operation, we need to write one firmware, right? So if you want to write the firmware, if you are having state machine model diagram in your hand, it is very easy to write the statements or or sketches, you can able to easily write the sketch. Okay, so literally you are sitting for writing the code for this kind of machine means there will be a lot and lot of problems will be there. So you should not get the correct set of code without using this state machine model, because the state machine model is especially for the embedded system, which is coming under the category of event driven model. Okay, without the state machine model, without the state machine diagram, you are not able to write the codes for such kind of applications that we already discussed for the examples called seatbelt warning systems and this TR coffee vending machine, and even you can go through so many examples in your real life, like ATM machine. Okay, that ATM machine is also an event driven model, and also the telephone, 1 rupee coin telephone. Okay, whatever, these are all the very very good examples for event driven models. Okay, whenever if you want to write the programs for such kind of applications, you should write in the way that where you have to use state machine model diagrams. With the help of the diagram only, you can able to create the codes or firmware for that applications. Okay, without this, if you are simply going in that way, means if you are simply writing the program with the help of this data flow graph model, it is not possible to write the codes, because data flow graph model is nothing but it is also a computational model for an embedded system like calculator. Okay, calculator is nothing but calculator is not event driven model. This is a simple arithmetic model. So this is a simple arithmetic model. Okay, arithmetic model means A plus B, there will be an answer. A minus B, there will be answer. So this is based upon the data whatever we are flowing, giving into that graph. Okay, whatever the data you are giving into the system will work according to it. So this is a simple technique. Okay, you can just write the code without having any kind of diagrams or any kind of model design is not necessary for this kind of application like calculators. But in case of state machine, seat belt warning systems or tea or coffee vending machines, like these are all the very important event driven models. So again and again I'm repeating that for these kind of event driven model, state machine model based firmware development is very suitable.